On January 23rd this year, 356 legislators out of 529 in Parliament voted to censure Persis Namuganza, the State Minister for Lands, Housing and Urban Development, after she was found guilty of gross misconduct. However, since then, the President has remained silent on the matter, yet Article 118 of the Constitution gives him the last say on the fate of a censured minister. Yesterday, Namuganza made her way back to the floor of Parliament for the first time since she was censured. To surprise the House, the embattled minister occupied the front bench designated for ministers as if nothing happened. Attempts by some legislators to protest her actions were failed by the presiding officer, Anita Among, who did not give much attention to the matter.
Honorable Speaker, this afternoon, Honorable Persis Namuganza, who was on the paper card of this year, January, unanimously censored in this parliament by a very, because of his behavior, you know, speaker, all members of the parliament. You know. So she was indicted by this parliament. I'm surprised that this afternoon she has majestically walked in the same parliament and sat on the front bench where the honorable ministers are supposed to be sitting. Regional Speaker, would you be proceeding well when somebody at this parliament has indicted, incensed at her, and even sent the notice to the attention of the President as per our rules of procedure to come from this and walk like a minister and sit like a minister?
However, some legislators were left disappointed, wondering why the president has not taken appropriate action against his censured minister, whose fate was decided by the House 6 weeks ago.
It's true, and that's why you saw that the members of parliament were not happy for a member who has been impeached to come and sit with us. It gives a bad picture, it undermines parliament, it gives a bad impression. But I want to call upon the president to carry out his duty diligently and very swiftly so that we can be in a position to, you know, give a precedent.
They urged the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, to officially write to the president to establish the action he took against Namuganza since the censure resolution was taken by Parliament.
What we can only do in terms of action is for the Speaker to write to the president, to remind the president of his obligations under the Constitution.
It's not too late. I want to tell the president that you do your due diligence very fast. You look for replacements so that this minister can be in a position to step aside. It gives a good precedent to us, the actions of parliament, and to also strengthen our conviction in what we are doing.
Others console themselves that the House is not to blame for the failure by the president to sack censured Namuganza, since they did their part as the law dictates.
The rules say the obligation of parliament over a censured minister. When you read Article 118 of our constitution, once a minister is censured, and read it together with our rules of procedure, rule 106, 107, 108, up to around 111. Once a minister is censured, that minister, two things are supposed to happen. Either he or she resigns, or the president takes appropriate action. Under the law, appropriate action is not explained. So the framers of the law were silent on it. The president can keep quiet the way he has kept quiet. The president can sack you. The president can transfer you. The word appropriate action is very broad. As far as Parliament is concerned, we discharged our obligation.
Chris Obore noted that there is no further action at Parliament's disposal against the minister if she chooses not to resign and return to the House.
Not going to act like what? A jungle. Parliament is a people-centered parliament. All our citizens are free to come to Parliament. Don't expect us to get pangas and access to chase people. But if you are following the censor, the censor through Parliament went through its procedures, and it's in another area. Go and find out from there.
Story by Fred Kajibi for the news.